Welcome back to my channel. This is day three, the belief system, not only in God, but belief in self. And we're actually going to stick in one area about the victim consciousness of self. So victim consciousness is based in three areas, a rescuer, a persecutor, and a victim. So you have a person who has had a lot of experiences in their past where maybe God has failed them in a certain area. Or maybe God has been great to them and they feel the only best way to be grateful to God is to be that rescuer. Here's the downside about rescuers. Sometimes they can be imbalanced. They give so much and they can do it for a variety of reasons. It could be because God was always there for me, so I need to be there for others. You know what? God wasn't there for me and I don't want anyone else to feel that way. I'm gonna be there for them. Sometimes they create codependency. Sometimes they'll rescue them so much that you'll find that you've created an ungrateful person who doesn't know how to really reason from cause to effect because you're always in there keeping them from their penalties. The difficulty with rescuers is that they'll become very depressed because they're always trying to attain to some kind of value or appreciation that would really never come. The thing is, they're playing God's role and they'll feel what God feels. There are people who don't mean harm, but they will never be able to give you the value you're looking for what you're giving. When dealing with rescuers, they have to pull back and ask God, should I do this? Is this what you want me to do? Because there's nothing wrong with having compassion upon people and being there to help them, but you should always do it with the balance from God. Then there's the victim. The victim always feels that, you know, everything always happens bad for me. And then you have some that says, you know, it's pointless to think about it. Just let them do it. It'll probably be better that way. Whatever I touch probably get messed up. The victim, they're always bad. They're always wrong. They're always in need. They draw the rescuers and they also draw the persecutors. Now the persecutors who are like, I'm right, do my way clearly and you're gonna pay the penalty when you don't. Or even the more subtle ones, like, you know what time it is? It's 8 o'clock, you need to hurry up and get to work. The key with the persecutor is that they cannot control what's going on in their lives. So they need to control you. And there are people with the rescuer, with the persecutors, and unless these people in your life know this, they're always going to be happy. Inside, don't want to tell you that you're broken, that you're messed up, because they need you to feed off of. So don't always expect someone to be that cheering section for you when you're trying to do good in life. Because there are people who in this victim consciousness triangle, they're either trying to rescue you from you being messed up, trying to tell you what to do in your messed up because they're messed up, or always feeling like I'm always messed up and want the pity party and want to actually pull you down with them and never give you positivity, but always show you the negative aspect of things. We call it pessimism. So ask yourself, who am I? What am I called to be? What belief system do I have about myself? Do I see myself as a weak person? Do I see myself as the person that has to be the rescuer, fighting for everything, making sure that everything is right? Do I have to be the persecutor? Do I have to be the person who makes sure that things are done right by any means necessary? Even if it's nagging, even if it's gossiping, even if it's criticizing. Who am I? And do I like it? Who am I? And is it shaping the outcome I want to change today? This is Raven for Regaining Eden with Raven. We're regaining Eden one decision at a time. If you like this video, like, share, and subscribe. Bye.